The Millennium Development Authority, MIDA, has been directed to halt all activities related to the partial privatization of the Electricity Company of Ghana, ECG, until it receives directives from the President. Now, the Chief of Staff, Julius Debra, is said to have given the directive at a meeting involving MIDA representatives, ECG management members, and members of the Electricity Union. Members of the Public Utilities Workers Union, PUU, have embarked on a series of industrial actions aimed at putting pressure on government to reconsider its decision. And let's speak to Michael Nyantichi. He's the General Secretary of the Public Utilities Workers Union, PUU. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much for your time.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Were your members part of this particular meeting we are talking about, where the directive has been given to MIDA to suspend every activity leading to the concession of part of ECG?
Yeah, I think first let me make it clear that I'm not sure that is exactly the true reflection of what transpired at the meeting.
Okay.
Yes, we were present at the meeting. Following the concerns we have raised, the chief of staff called us, I think, the previous week, and he later also spoke with MIDA. And then the two parties were called together to meet at the chief of staff office. We met, and then from the angle of MIDA, they were more or less coming to discuss only issues relating to the request for proposals which they have issued to the prospective bidders.
Okay.
But the Public Utility Workers Union made the chief of staff aware that our issues go beyond just the request for proposal, and that we think we have more serious concerns. We are going to sit to discuss the issues. We want it to be a broader and open discussion than just focusing only on the...
Am I to understand that at the meeting, that wasn't the final outcome, that MIDA should hold on until further clarification is sought?
No, so let me... That's what I'm trying to explain by giving you a little background so that we get the thing in the correct perspective. So the meeting yesterday was convened at the office of the chief of staff. The chief of staff was not present at the meeting. He delegated one of the presidential staffers, honorable, what do you call him?
Someone to represent him.
Yes, honorable Chibosi Akunsechere.
Okay.
Chaired the meeting. So we discussed and raised our issues. And some of the issues we raised were such that they were matters which MIDA could not provide the answers. They were issues of policy that required a further decision by the policy makers.
Okay.
So what was agreed at the meeting yesterday was that in order for all the parties to be sure that the social dialogue we have that is not just mere rules, but a proper discussion is ongoing.
Mm-hmm.
Then there are certain key activities that MIDA was about to carry out. So it's specifically related to the bidders conference that MIDA was going to hold on the 3rd of October,
mm-hmm.
and then granting access to the data room for prospective bidders to have access to whatever information and documents.
All right. So what next, the two
issues that we said that for the discussions to be fair and not just a pretend, hold on to those two key activities.
Okay.
So it's not that a directive has been given that MIDA should stop all activities they are doing in relation to the...
All right, thank you for the concession clarification. So what next for PUU and with relation to the ECG issue? What's the next major line of action?
Yeah, so we have raised some key issues which are of policy concern. So the meeting agreed that these matters will be taken up to the authorities, either the chief of staff, the presidency, whoever has the authority to take a decision on those things. And the outcome of those issues we have raised will then inform our next
line of action.
So for now, this is what really transpired there. It's not a directive that neither should completely halt all activities, but
it was
two specific things that we requested that if the dialogue
should be considered
sincere and genuine, then they should suspend those activities.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much for the clarification. Michael Nyantechi is the General Secretary of the Public Utilities Workers Union, PUBU. It is still an unfolding story. We'll keep an eye on it for you. And I